People, welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Serpy. Now, my older subscribers may remember when I did this video covering the whole Dida Nemad and some political links you had here in Jamaica. Right, you can check out that video on my channel. Now, I thought that was the end of it. But on Sunday, I realized Dida Nemad was back in the news. Now, for those of you who are not aware, Dida Nemad, right, Dida is his nickname. His real name is Naris Nemad, and his nickname is Dido, right? He was identified back in 2004 by the then US President George Bush, right, as he was designated a top drug kingpin in Jamaica, right? And he was named along with some other officials, right? Probably the other most prominent name you may remember is Liebert Ramcharan, right? So he had a number of properties and vehicles that he gets seized from him, right? I think he may not lose 5 properties and 11 vehicles to the state, right? People, 11 vehicles, right? So people were celebrating this at the time because people were saying, well, yes, there you go. The Jamaica Assets Recovery Agency starts putting some work, because, you know, people always say, well, when people make their money certain ways, certain illegal ways, then the system and the government should be able to take it back, right? No. He appealed against this, right? And he was going through different courts, and on Sunday, it came out in the Observer that he has failed, right? So his appeal has failed, means the government will get for Wolan, Panda Austin, and the 11 vehicle them, right? They also recovered some tractors and some motor trucks and all the assets, people, right? And take away Benz and all kind of things. He had a lot of assets, right? But at the time, people were saying, well, this not go hold, or this not go stick, because they must have really done them having politicians link and all that. But people, there you go, it actually stick. So now that's what they say, Jamaica Assets Recovery Agency can take away back some of these things and hold on upon them. Make we see if this is going to be a landmark case where them start spread it across the board. Because this doesn't happen often enough, right? I always think to myself, well, how come they use a certain man? Certain man who them say are definitely this and definitely that. How come they come, how them get locked up, sentenced, and then get full lamp and everything with them keep? So, I mean, I would love to see the law surrounding how things can get forfeited to the state, right? And what conditions have to be met, because I don't know, this case, this Dida Nemad case, is probably definitely the biggest one, but it just seemed to me like it doesn't happen often enough, right? And I imagine the laws surrounding the state being able to forfeit certain things and take back certain things must be tricky, because you have to go then prove, say, it was illegal money you buy that, right? And trust me, if those laws were to properly be enforced in Jamaica, if the Jamaican government was supposed to start, listen, we're going to start take back assets that come from illegal money. People of Jamaica, let me tell you this. Enough, man. Things gone a morning. And you know this law. You see this thing where them use sink, lead on them and take on property them? If they were to enact this across the board, whole heap of 116s, right? Where they pan on the TV in a jacket and tie, they might lose for them property. Right, so trust me, people, don't think so. This is going to start get spread out across the board, left, right, and center. This thing, they're gonna have a few cases that deal in them out to say, yes, it will work, but trust me, this will not become mainstream anytime soon. If them start take back things that bill and buy out illegal, illegal money, Jamaica, either those the property and assets to start get missing all of a sudden. Trust me, a lot of your favorite people, a lot of your favorite brands, let's say your favorite businesses, major corporations in Jamaica, they were started with illegal money, especially drug money. Now, people, understand this. Them lock up Dida Nemad in 2004. Him tried to fight the extradition until about 2008, where he lost all the different appeals, and him end up extraditing. Him end up in America, right, and in January 2009, right, he pled guilty to conspiracy to distribute more than 5 key of white powder and more than 1,000 key of herbs. Now, people, let me tell you why this Dida Nemad case is interesting. I already mentioned his political links, and for those of you who don't know, I'm going to go back into it. Don't worry yourself. Right, I'm going to post the info that came out on WikiLeaks surrounding this man. But you may remember, I did a recent video saying that Uncle Sam don't really care about the whole crime, this and fighting crime. When they say Uncle Sam take a certain man and carry him go foreign, really, Uncle Sam just want to get some info, give him a short sentence and send him back a road. People, when you look at the numbers around the Deed and Nemad case, hey, you have to scratch your head. You know why you have to scratch your head, people? Think about this. Deed and Nemad went to America. First of all, he got called out, right, named by, as I said, the former president, George Bush, as a top drug kingpin in Jamaica. I think he was listed as one of the top 10. So by Jamaican standards, this man was moving serious weight, right? Serious weight. Especially him and Liberal Ramcharan. Now, people, he got sentenced initially to, guess how much year he get? Guess, because remember, we know, say, America is a place where man I get fling off your spliff. Especially a black Jamaican man. Listen, they mean fling you off anything. Guess how much time he get? 13 years. But it got even better for old Deed and Nemad. See, initially he got sentenced to 13 years. So you already know that deal, right? Whatever him work out with them was a sweet deal. But then it got reduced even further. It got reduced to 9 years after the 13. Now you're thinking, why? Deed and Nemad, him really get sorted out properly. Them really deal with him nice, man. That nice package him get. Oh, it gets even better. Because, as I said, sentenced to 13, reduced to 9. He came out in 2015. Bearing in mind, he got sentenced in January 2009. So just call it 6 years, right? Let's just call it 6 years. People of Jamaica, 6 years? How do you think a top drug kingpin, a major drug kingpin who was named, right, get called out, go through one bag of excitement for extradition, end up in an Uncle Sam jail system, and come back a road in a 6 years? Guess how you do that? See, people of Jamaica, I tell you all the time, Uncle Sam just want the info. That's all he want. Listen, come over here, sir. Come talk to me. What you know? Tell you what you know, and then you can go on back to your yard. Nobody tell you about how much money. Nobody want to hear about how much care he sell. Waste of thing. Waste of time. People of Jamaica. Jamaican drug kingpins on the global scale are small time. How many times do I have to tell people that? Think of any big down on one name. As big as anything, them is them only big by Jamaican standards. Them are small timer. Other countries, for them drug kingpins end up on the Forbes list. Right about billions of US dollars. Our drug kingpins, small time. By Jamaican standards, they're crazy rich, of course. If you have 5 million US dollars in Jamaica, you're crazy rich. But that can't get you nowhere foreign. So when you see America go through all them problems, the care of certain man go foreign, aim for them more. And people at Jamaica, think about this. Make a look back on the year them, right? Deed and Nemad got 13 years, reduced to 9, come out in 6. Liberate Ramcharan, you know how much him get? 35. 35 years. The man, America extradited two man them. Right? A couple of them, well, they get extradited. There was also Rob Roy Williams and Glenford Williams and Vivian Daly and Robert Henry, who was, I think he was a former police. Right? People, one bag of man gone foreign. Liberate Ramcharan get 35 years. Deed and Nemad get 13, then 9, come out in 6. Now, let's look at the year again. People, 2009 was when he got sentenced. Think about that. Now, earlier I mentioned he had some political links. Look at your screen right now, please. In 2004, right, DEA sources linked Norris Deed and Nemad, right, to three prominent members of the JLP. James Robertson, we all know about him. Shaheen Robinson, and the current Minister of Security, Horace Chang. As being involved, you can read it on your screen, people, as being involved with money laundering and organized crime by local sources. People of Jamaica, again, focus on the year. The numbers are important. 2004, the exact same year Dido Nemad got arrested. Now, remember, he never actually go to America until 2008, and he got sentenced in 2009. People of Jamaica, guess what happened? After Dido Nemad do him deal and sign him the sign and take him plea and do all these things, 2009, in 2011, guess who lose them visa? You remember now? None other than James Robertson. Not only did he lose his visa, but his wife also lost hers. Sounds familiar with another current serving member, right? See, it's real strange, right? We kind of see the same thing happening over and over again, right? You see, May Daryl Vaz lost his, then his wife lose fair one. See, it look like seven Uncle Sam take with the man one, and just take with the wife home like him and say, you think, see, I can make your wife come, and take with two of them, right? Now, people at Jamaica understand this, right? All I'm saying is, the timing is spooky, because man get an incredible 13 years for move so much product, right? Then get dropped down to 9 years. Then get dropped down to a 5 people. That means the story keep getting better and better. Uncle Sam, I get more and more. Because 2009, you get sentenced, right? 2011, one of the man them who you were accused of, right? Lose fame visa. Right now we know James Robertson, he get called and all kind of things. Man, he all got a friend, go testify, say, fear for life and all kind of things. But understand what I'm saying here, people. Remember my video where I said Uncle Sam wants leverage. He wants leverage because if him find out, say, for example, this drugs man, yeah, I link with a top member of a political party, when him get that man in a foreign and say, yo, what you know about so and so? What you and him do? What him give you? Talk to me. When drugs boss give up certain information about certain politicians, Uncle Sam will land on it, right? And strike at the most convenient time, right? Now, you remember, James Robertson was on the verge of becoming very powerful in Jamaica. As a matter of fact, he made it up the way, all the way up to Deputy Prime Minister. See, some people don't remember that, you know? James Robertson was on his way to becoming, to go right to the top of the JLP. And Uncle Sam strike conveniently, right, at a point was sink him. He went from deputy leader to the point where I think right now he's just an MP. Just he went from deputy leader to not even at the cabinet no more. Now he's just an MP, right? Uncle Sam strike at the most perfect and opportune time. People at Jamaica, remember the other names who the DEA sources claim say Dido Nemad, and the WikiLeaks sources claim that Dido Nemad the linked. You see who else is on that list? Yes, the current Minister of National Security. So who knows what information Uncle Sam probably have on him? And as I said in my other video, it's all about leverage. Once you have this information, imagine having certain incriminating information on a country's national, the Minister of National Security. Come on, people. Do you know how powerful that is? To be able to say to somebody, say, listen, where you depend? And the person say, yo, me not take no chat from you. And you can answer back and say, oh, really? Really, I remember one time, Joe Kingpin, they tell you, say, do this and give you these recordings and give you these pictures. You remember that? You have to keep quiet. People, that's the power of leverage. Right? That is what Uncle Sam want. That's all Uncle Sam want. That is the strength, people. That is the focus. Uncle Sam does not extradite no man from Jamaica if you go all the way to America, right? So that's him can give him a little 13 or 9 years in a jail. It's not even worth the time. It's not even worth the time. Uncle Sam wants leverage, right? So he can use it, right, to get certain things done, right? Anytime people start step out of line, right, Uncle Sam just ring them phone and remind them, say, yo, have your file, right? So when you see certain people just lose them visa out of nowhere, right? And they say, oh, I want one. I don't hear saying shoot nobody. Of course you don't. And enough of them things it a come from, right? Is information where certain dons and jockeys go find, go leak, and give Uncle Sam, right? People of Jamaica, understand this. You see, when you really think about it, this visa thing in Jamaica, right? Jamaican politicians are probably sure for visa. I can't even take these politicians seriously. Imagine a sovereign nation, right? Imagine a so-called independent nation where another country can just take away your visa and it come like you get a heavyweight knockout in your face. Imagine, think about that, right? Jamaican politicians brag about who have and who don't have US visa. That's how powerful it is. Somebody sent me a clip. I remember somebody sent me a clip with a PNP politician. I think it was Crawford, and he was doing this speech, and he pulled out a line, and he was like, "And me have my visa," and the crowd went wild. Jamaican politicians are a poppy show. Visa, Uncle Sam, no say. As big and bad as Jamaican politicians want to be, just snatching away them visa cut them down to size. Jamaican 116s and politicians only have strength for poor people and regular Jamaicans, because something as simple as a visa can make them fall in line anytime they go on at them bad. Anytime Uncle Sam make a request and they get it, he just pull out those powerful four letters, V-I-S-A, and watchman fall in a line. Watchman stop going like them powerful. Watchman start tremble. Oh Lord, not my visa. It's a joke. When you have a country, where next country can use access to feeding country for bring your country leaders in line, that's a joke. A complete joke. Oh well. Patreon squad, big up on yourself. Please like, comment, and share the video. Bless.